Hi there, my name is Sarah Moran, and today we'll be discussing green financing and why Northern Ireland companies should be aware of trends. At its simplest, green finance is any financial product or service that ensures an improved environmental outcome, such as encouraging development of green projects, minimizing impact on the climate, or both. Mounting regulatory pressures on the finance sector will progressively reorientate capital away from brown companies and activities towards green, sustainable activities. Banks in Northern Ireland, such as Danske Bank, Bank of Ireland, and Ulster Bank, now need to assess each and every corporate lend based on the customer's sustainability credentials. And in the future, this is likely to influence both access to and cost of finance. The green finance agenda is influenced by both push and pull factors from regulators and the real economy. In 2015, landmark international agreements were concluded with the adoption of the UN Sustainable Development Goals and the Paris Climate Agreement, which includes the commitment to align financial flows with a pathway towards low carbon and climate resilient development. Within the UK, the government's green finance strategy, Transforming Finance for a Greener Future, outlines how the finance sector and better climate disclosure from corporate actors can drive progress in relation to climate change and help the UK achieve its net zero emissions target. In 2021, the government set out its high-level intentions to impose new reporting obligations, which will go beyond existing Task Force on Climate-Related Financial Disclosures, or TCFD-aligned reporting, to which many sectors in the economy are already or will become subject. Also on the horizon, a UK green taxonomy is under development, which will classify certain business activities as green in line with environmental objectives. Similar themes are echoed in Europe, with the European Green Deal representing a growth strategy aiming to make Europe the first climate neutral continent by 2050. The strategy is also underpinned by initiatives such as the EU taxonomy and reporting initiatives which mandate companies to report on their climate impacts. From a reputational standpoint, through membership of initiatives such as the Global Financial Alliance for Net Zero, or GFANZ, many financial institutions have publicly committed to reducing their financed emissions by setting science-based targets and accelerating their ambitions to decarbonize portfolios. Undeniably, momentum is gathering pace around brand purpose, a reason to exist beyond making money, with customers switching products or services when a company violates their values. There are growing market opportunities for companies willing and ready to respond. Brands that deliver on pursuit of purpose, that drive a culture of sustainable innovation, are at the front runners in the eyes of consumers, customers, and external stakeholders, and they are watching. In the near term, green credentials are likely to improve access to capital with marginal impact on cost, as banks are not yet required to adjust capital ratios in line with climate exposures, although this will come. New green products are continually emerging, such as use of proceeds bonds, sustainable linked loans, green project finance, along with emergence of innovative de-risking options, such as blended finance, to support the green transition. However, this position is expected to shift in the medium term, with capital cost becoming impacted, triggering increasing sophistication of green finance products and associated metrics or key performance indicators for companies to report on, allowing financiers to track the transition pathway of their portfolios towards green. In the longer term, resilience to climate impacts will become a critical factor in determining both access to and cost of capital, as financial institutions actively look to mitigate future exposures to climate. Essentially, corporates will need to demonstrate the resilience of their business to climate impacts in order to attract and retain capital. So what does it mean for Northern Ireland industry? Financiers will apply the following lenses to your business to assess your level of resilience and risk as the economy transitions to green. Firstly, the potential revenue at risk arising from failure to demonstrate green credentials to consumers in business activities and/or product ranges. Secondly, the carbon intensity of your business and potential exposure of your business to changes in carbon price, including ability to finance decarbonisation ambitions and transition to green. Thirdly, the resilience of the business assets to the impacts of climate change and ability to finance and insure assets into the future. To protect access to and cost of capital, the following steps are recommended. Firstly, know your position. Assess both the impact of your business on the environment and reciprocal impact of the environment and green transition on your business under the following lenses: revenue, OPEX, CAPEX, and carbon. Assess the level of alignment of your business activities with the taxonomy. Second, make a plan. Construct a transition plan to demonstrate how your business intends to mitigate risks and capitalize on opportunities. Determine what constitutes a sustainable investment for your business, along with associated timelines and capital requirement. And lastly, shop around for the best fit product to suit your needs. Consider green finance products which are tailored to your business profile and transition plan. That concludes the webinar, and many thanks for listening.